With the recent increase in battery prices across the board, brands like EG4 have gotten a little far out of reach for everyday consumers. If you don't need something UL listed, the EcoWorthy batteries are a fraction of the price. But are they worth the savings, or should you save up for something just a little bit better? That's what we're here to find out. Welcome back to the lab where our opinions can't be bought. The big difference between these cheap batteries and more expensive ones are their ability to be legally installed or UL listed. But before we get going, check the link down below for any coupon codes we can get out of EcoWorthy, this month's giveaway, and subscribe if you haven't already. Now let's get into our spec teardown. First up, this thing weighs 95 pounds, which makes it extremely hard to handle because there are no handles. It's got a 5,120 watt battery bank, and it's rated for 100 amps of continuous use discharge. Now the BMS says it has typical protection for temperature, overcharge, discharge, all those sorts of things. And they say it's rated for 6,000 cycles at an 80% depth of discharge. In terms of design, it's pretty simple. You've got your basic terminal connections on the front, all your communication ports. It doesn't have any handles, which again, makes it a little hard to carry around. One thing that it is missing is the lack of a screen, which was a little bit annoying during our testing. And it has no fire arresters and potentially maybe a temperature sensor. It didn't really look like one, but it does say it has temperature monitoring systems, so maybe it was one. With all that being said, this unit's $1,299, but with a permanent sale and our discount, that gets you down to $799, which is significantly less than an EG4 unit, but is it worth the savings? Starting off with what we like, the battery can handle long surges above that 100 amp rating. Whether that's a good thing or a bad thing in terms of the battery health, I guess we'll find out. We also like the terminal connections. They are good forward-facing terminal connections, easy to get to with your battery wiring, whether you're in or out of a server rack cabinet. And we also liked that the housing is all pretty well built. It's a solid unit, easy to open and access the interior if you ever needed to, and no sharp catches or anything in terms of carrying the unit around. Now, speaking of the internal layout while we're there, it does have a pretty good clean layout. You can see that they've taken a little bit of time to work on like efficient layouts between the battery cells and then where they're gonna have the main board at the front of the unit. We just couldn't really see many of the safety measures that you might find inside a higher end, more expensive battery. Now, with not having a screen, there's one other way to access any of the settings in that, and that is through Bluetooth and the app, which works not too bad. It gives you the basics, everything that you need to know in terms of where the battery's at with its internal temperatures, its charge rates, its discharge rates. And that's pretty good considering the price of this thing is $799. So to start off with things that we don't like, we've already mentioned it a couple times, but the handles. Every time I moved this thing around the lab, it was a pain in the ass. No handles on the front, nothing that you can screw to it to add handles if you wanted to. It made it really hard, whether it's lifting it onto a table, testing it out in a server rack cabinet, there's just no way comfortably to carry it. It's awkward and heavy. And it does actually show handles on their website, so don't be fooled if you're buying this. It might not look exactly as presented online. The next thing that we don't like was that it failed our temperature test. We threw this guy in the freezer overnight, got it down below minus 20 degrees, and we found when we went to turn it on that the BMS system wasn't entirely doing what they advertised that it should. And on the side, it says that there should be no discharge voltage below that threshold. And when we put our voltage tester on it, it was still putting out 52 volts while it was below that negative 20. So really, you might look at that and think, oh, that's great. It performed well in cold weather. This thing's still gonna do the job. Maybe. But at the same time, is that good for the lifetime of your battery? Or are you gonna be paying the price down the road? So the other weird thing that we found with this unit was that the BMS system kind of works dependent on the breaker on the battery being on. With other units, you can have the battery breaker off, which would allow you to like service the battery, change the terminals, work on your inverter, but still have your battery monitoring system turned on so that you can access it through the app, through the Bluetooth, or a screen if that unit had a screen. But in this case, having that battery monitoring system on didn't mean anything if you didn't turn the power to the battery itself on. And then it makes you question like, what is it really doing if you have to have the battery turned on for that to work? Meaning if your battery is off, is the battery still being monitored? Or is there still voltage going on that you don't know what's going on That was weird. going on. I don't know what the f- going on. Is it working or isn't it? So lastly, we also tried to call for support. And EcoWorthy didn't even pick up the phone.
Please leave your name, number, and a brief message and someone will return your call. Thank you.
So we recommend that if you are looking at buying this unit, knowing that, you know, you might be taking a sacrifice on quality, but the price is there for you, then maybe looking at buying this through Shop Solar. So overall, after the time we spent with this unit in the lab, it was a pretty solid unit. If you're looking at using it in an off-grid setting like a cabin, a tiny home, or in a garden shed, it's pretty good. So I don't know how it would do in the long term. I wouldn't necessarily put it in my house as a primary source of backup power, but overall, we were pretty happy with its performance. For now, that's all we have for you guys. Don't forget to check the link down below for any coupon codes we can get a hold for you, and subscribe, check out this month's giveaways. But for now, peace out and stay charged.